Hello, I'm Lynne Truss, and it's my great pleasure to welcome you to the rather strange world of tidal talk from the Rockpool here at the QEH Theatre in Bristol as part of BBC Radio 4's More Than Words Festival, featuring the innermost thoughts of a periwinkle, a hermit crab, an anemone, a goby fish, a limpet, and a lugworm. These monologues were first written in the mid-1990s, and I'll never forget how my brilliant producer so cleverly managed to trick a cast of amazing actors into playing these small, primitive, uninspiring organisms. You'll notice that your contract says you're playing a periwinkle, she would have said to them. Well, just ignore that, obviously. It's just a BBC thing. Periwinkle is our way of saying, Pericles. Now, that was 15 years ago, and you wouldn't think the same trick would work twice, especially on some of the same people. But fantastically it has, and I can't wait to hear these scripts brought alive again by the marvellous cast we have for you. And here is the wonderful Bill Wallace as not Pericles, you'll be pleased to hear, but the Periwinkle.
All right then. Are you all right, missus? Good. Anyway, there's this big shark and this whale. Whale, shark, whale. So, the big shark chucks down this squid what's got a terrible cough. Squid with a cough, eh? And the shark says to the whale, "Here's that sick squid I owe you." Here's that sick squid. Six quid. Yeah. All right. I'll see you later then. Not if you see me first, right? Bye then. Bye-bye. Oh, God, those limpets are hard work. I say to them, you should get out more. I say to them, anyone here from Coventry? Have you heard the one about the crab prosecuted for possession of soft prawn, hard prawn and kiddie prawn? Hey? Nothing. Well, it's like telling jokes to a row of Chinaman's hats. Inscrutable. Well, you suit yourselves, I say. I'll be back tomorrow on my rounds, come hell or high water, keeping Britain tidy. You get it? Tidy. You say, tide, right? With an E on it, eh? Oh, well, worse things happen at sea. We do get all sorts around here, you know, but as an audience, well, they're all rubbish. Oh, Mr. Periwinkle, says the oldest limpet to me once, lifting up the old Chinaman's hat very grand, so high you could see the skirt underneath. Call me Perry, I says, with a wink. Mr. Periwinkle, I have lived a very long time. I have survived life-altering sex changes, and I am stuck with a tenacity beyond your imaginings to this big rock. Now, your common little sort may skitter about all mobile on your big foot and tumble with your associates in the surf and don't say you don't because I've heard you. But please, feel under no obligation to entertain us all the time. Because to be honest, it makes me tired. Well, just because I'm a common periwinkle doesn't mean I put up with all that old nonsense from the old dowager lady high and dry. So I gets well up close and I whispers, "Shell suits are right out of fashion, haven't you heard?" And I puts the old foot in gear and motors off sharpish. Oh, I do like to be beside the seaside. Oh, I do like to be inside the sea. Oh, I do... Oh. Hello. What's this then? Okay. Nice bit of seaweed here. Oh, yes. I've got a sharp tongue, I have. Comes in useful in a rock pool, I can tell you. I've got no worries about my teeth wearing out. No, because, basically, lovely. My teeth just keep going. On my tongue. Yeah. Bet you didn't know that. That is a little known fact, that is. These sets of teeth on my tongue, they sort of move forward as required. Yeah. There's very little French kissing in the periwinkle world. Which is a shame in some ways, obviously. But on the plus side, here I am with my biting wit. So it all evens out, I reckon. But it isn't easy keeping cheerful. Not with the sort of stony crowd to get round here. A word in your shell, like I say. But you just can't get a rise out of them. That miserable old hermit crab, dear, oh dear. Are you dressed? I call to him. Dressed crab, right, yeah. Pointless. He went for me once with his pincer. I said, whew, bit nippy round here, or is it me? Oh, I do like to be beside a seaside. I do like to be... So why do I bother trying to spread a bit of happiness round here? I'll tell you why. Because we've only got one life, haven't we? And one day, the big carnivorous bloke with the bent pin comes along. I bet you've never thought what it's like to be yanked out of your little shell and eaten, have you? Well, you're the lucky one. Personally, I have given it some very serious consideration. And winkles against winkling. That's my manifesto. What annoys me about it is that Brother Snail, he gets it easy. Why is that? You decent, ordinary thinking English people, they won't eat snails, quite right. Won't touch the escargots. But when they get to the seaside, they see us periwinkles minding our own business, and it's like they lose all their self-control. It's disgusting. That's what it is. Barbaric. Oh, yum, yum, yum. Little winkles. Oh, drop of vinegar. Lovely. I repeat, eating winkles is disgusting and ought to be illegal. Right. I better get on. Oh, I do like to be beside the seaside. Oh, I do like to be beside the sea. Oh, I do like to stroll along a prom, 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 where the brass bands play tiddly, um, pom, pom. I found my best mate sitting on the sand yesterday. Give him nudge, I did. Hello, hello, I says. All right. And over he goes. Just an empty shell. He was gone and never called me mother. Brown bread he was. And he hadn't popped out voluntary. You know what I mean? He hadn't nipped out for a packet of Spangles. Oh, no. What you good people don't appreciate is that every empty shell is a death. Now, personally, I have personally escaped death. Oh, yes. Cue sound effects, please. Right, because, but this is God's honest, I am trawling along this very rock one day when along comes this ginormous seagull. You know, wings, beak, beady eye, they're all works. Well, there's no time to fend him off, all clever with, oh, I know you, was it Blackpool? Before he picks me up and swallows me. No messy, I'm swallowed. Up, good and proper, and that's that.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.